Everyone, welcome to your channel Pharmacypedia. This is Dr. Shikha Chauhan, and in this session, I'm going to discuss a very important GPAC notification. So the GPAC notification is issued recently in the last week on 23rd December. So I'm going to share few quite important tips, suggestions, which will help the GPAC scholars. So my dear students, let us begin to get and understand the GPAC 2021 test series status. So this is the information bulletin. This information bulletin you can download from this website nta.ac.in. This is my sincere advice to each one of you, that those who are preparing for the GPAC, please download this information bulletin and go through it thoroughly. The reason being that there are several things that you should understand and you should know before filling up the form, because ultimately you need to understand that corrected form has to be submitted. So I'm not going to go through this vision and mission, because each one of you understand the importance of this GPAT examination. GPAT examination is very important for pharmacy students if you want to avail the scholarships during your master's program, and that too through very good institutes. So let us go finally through the detailed instructions which have to be sent. So first thing, very important, is the date. So you can see the online registration has been started from 23rd December 2022, 22 January 2021. So my dear students, don't wait till the last time. Try to submit it early, 1 week prior, at least 1 week prior to your end date, which is 23rd January. So don't wait till the last moment. Go through this information bulletin in detail and understand each and every feature. And in case you do feel any doubt or query, you can reply in the comment section. So the fee structure, if you see critically, for the male candidates in the general is 2000 and in the categories is 1000, whereas the female candidates is 1000, whether from the general or from the backward categories. Now one thing important here is to know about the correction in the particulars of application which has been filled online only. So like, my dear students, if you have entered anything wrong while filling up the form, you can rectify it within this time frame. So please do understand it carefully. Anything entered wrong, it will be very harmful for all of you. So by any way, if you have entered any sort of the particular which is wrong, please rectify it after the form submission also, but within this time frame from 25th January to 30th January. Now very important to understand here is the date of examination. So as of now, two dates have been defined, and they can be on either of them, either 22nd February 2021 or 27th February 2021. So you have to understand the value of time. Now you have 2 months complete in your hand. You have to prioritize your planning. You have to make the strategies how smartly you can attempt the GPAC 2021. The talking about the duration of the exam, it is of 3 hours, 180 minutes. Then timings of the examination, again, this is also not fixed yet. It may happen from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. or 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. maybe in the morning shift or in the evening shift. Talking about the exam center, so one has to be very careful while filling up the examination centers. So at the last of the information bulletin, there are several center codes which have been provided. So in whatever area you are residing, you keep the center code as near as possible. So while filling up the code, please check it twice before giving that code in that examination center. Talking about the declaration of the results, it will be intimated through the websites only. So the website, both the websites are working, nta.ac.in and gpat.nta.nic.in. Now, GPAC 2021 will be thoroughly filled in the online mode. Only one application is to be submitted by a candidate. So sometimes it happens that candidates fill two applications, so this should not be done. You have to be very careful for that. You need to go through the information bulletin twice before actually filling up the form. So go through the information bulletin in detail, and in case you feel any doubt or query, there are helpline numbers also being provided at the end, and you can go through that. More than one application or multiple application forms submitted by the candidate will not be accepted. So again, this is very important. Now talking about the registration process. So this is the information bulletin that we are discussing. Next, you need to understand what are the different steps to be followed for the online application. So what are the things to be required? You have to have the scanned images of recent photographs. Now important here is to reduce the file size, that the scanned image should be within 10 KB to 200 KB. So again, like for the signature also, they have specified the file size in it, which can be uploaded easily, is the 4 KB to 30 KB. And about that, you have to particular make these things ready prior hand before filling up the forms. Then talking about the payment, that can be either through the Canara or ICICI Bank or Paytm payment gateway. So now with the Paytm, it is very easy, or you can have through the net banking also. So these are the general instructions which are being provided in any sort of the competitive examination. Being in the COVID era, now we have to look forward for the, if there are any sort of the COVID specific instructions. Yes, my dear students, you can see here brief advisory has been issued for the COVID-19 pandemic area time. So what are the additional things you have to carry along? Admit card along with the self declaration undertakings, which can be downloaded from the NTA website. Then simple transparent ballpoint pen or like any simple pen. Additional photograph to be pasted on the attendance sheet. Personal hand sanitizer. Now again, this is different from the previous years. You need to carry your own hand sanitizers. You need to carry your own transparent water bottle. And if the patient or the candidate is diabetic, in that case you can have some sort of the things too, like fruits or like your tablets. Then talking, these are the general instructions, like for any competitive exam, fair means have to be there. You should not carry any sort of the unfair means. Talking about the NTA agency, you know it very well. This agency is now been carrying out the GPAT examination from long time. So this, you understand, this score is accepted by all the AICTE approved institutions, university departments and colleges, affiliated colleges. So this is a 3 hours computer based online test. So these are the general instructions. NTA main role is to conduct the examination. They are not connected with the counseling or the admissions to the master's program. So now this is important. Now, my dear student, you should pay attention to this part. The reason being, if you see my earlier videos on the GPAT, you will find that like if you have to qualify for the GPAT, you need to understand what is the weightage being provided to each subject. For example, this time if the total questions are like 125 questions, so these are the number of questions. Now pharmaceutics is here accounting for 38 questions, and you can expect chemistry questions, 38 chemistry questions, cognosy 10, pharmacology 28, and other subjects 11. So it is my sincere advice that you actually take into account three main subjects: pharmacology, pharmaceutics and pharmaceutical chemistry. So what I feel is that students are doing well in pharmaceutics, doing well in cognosy as well, because 38 plus 10 48 questions are simply accounting from the pharmaceutics and cognosy part. So if you, even if your target is to simply qualify, you pay attention to three subjects: pharmaceutics, cognosy and oncology. And if you want to achieve the rank, you have to pay more attention to the chemistry part, because this time you can see if pharmaceutics and chemistry are having the equal weightage. So when they have the equal weightage, what sometimes I feel that in chemistry people don't have that much of the confidence. The oncology is reduced, like from now it is 28 only. So most of the time students are engaging themselves into pharmacology, pharmaceutics. But now what you have to understand here with the scheme and the pattern of examination, like give more weightage to the chemistry as well, because most of the students are working on the college and pharmaceutics. Cognosy they do it, but the people who will be able to do better in the chemistry will be able to achieve the good ranks. So my dear students, plan your study accordingly. Devote more time to the chemistry if you want to have a better rank, and if your objective is just to qualify, work hard for the pharmaceutics, cognosy and oncology. Surely you will qualify. Then talking about the syllabus, you can download. The syllabus is same. So talking about each question, carry 4 marks. For the correct response, you get the 4 marks, and for each incorrect response, you get the 1 marks is deducted from the total score. You are clear about this criteria. Now next, talking about the eligibility criteria, you can see the eligibility, it is open for the B Pharm students. So this is again the same, talking about the reservations. These are the reservations which are being as per any government competitive examinations. This is regarding the disabilities. The students who are falling into each of the categories, please go through the information bulletin in detail for that. Now this is again important, you should pay attention and you should clear yourself in the initial only before filling the form what will be your choice of exam center. Now this is again important here is that examination fees once paid will neither be refunded nor be carried forward under any circumstances. So by mistake if you have submitted it and once it is gone, it will be gone, it will not be refunded even if your form is not complete. So my dear students, complete the form, go through the instructions very carefully, don't fill the form directly. So this is the website, you can refer further for the details. Now talking about the registration and applications, these are the requirements. You should have all these things ready prior hand only so that you hassle free you can submit the application form. So my dear student, a computer with a good internet connectivity, particulars of a valid government ID proof, state of birth, all these qualification details in proper formats, scan clear signature images, bank account details. So all of these information you should have prior hand. And each and every instructions have been provided here. The application format is very easy once you have all these things. So get all these things done in a folder, collect all the things in a folder, then try up filling it that, and make this thing very clear. Once it is submitted, the fees will not be reimbursed in any case. So this is for the complete application form, photographs. So go through the next year part also very carefully, because the reason being these are the general instructions. So this is about the admit card, you have to follow the admit card. Admit card will be generated. Admit card will not be sent by the post. Okay. So these are the general instructions you have. Now this is for the centers, examination centers. You select the centers of your choice. Non-disclosure, unfair practices and means are like any other competitive examination, they are totally prohibited. So I am hereby right now going to show you the different annexures. Yes, these are the different annexures, like for the processing charges and GST. For the net banking, what are the additional, if you are paying through the ICICI bank or like Paytm. So they have even given the contact numbers whereby you can contact in case you find some problem. This is annexure 2. This is for the physical limitation. So the candidates who will be filling this form, they have to take care with this annexure part. Now annexure 3, this is the letter for undertaking using your own scribe. Then annexure 4. Now this is regarding the examination center. So my dear student, you can see the state with the code, city code. For Delhi it is 20 and DL01 is the code. So state wise you can see the codes have been provided. For Balasore it is OR02. So select your choice very clearly, don't by mistake fill it wrong number, because once it is entered, it will be that only. And in case you feel that you have entered something wrong, still you have the correction window will be open from 25th January to 30th January. So this is the way it will be appearing it. So go through these annexures very carefully, how this like not visited or not answered, red marked, green marked for the answered, marked for the review. So go through these instructions very carefully while giving the examination. These are the examination instructions being provided. So you have to navigate through it very carefully. Don't press the final submit unless you are clear about it. Now this is the application for the online registration of the candidate. So this is the sign in page. So these are just a way you go through these ones, because this will help you in filling the form correctly. Keep all the things ready, make a folder on your desktop, and the snapshots will help you. Go through these snapshots once you have collected the data and then fill up the form. I think you can easily download it from the NTA website. This will really help you. My sincere advice to all of you is that since you're left with almost 2 months now, 60 days you have, plan your study in a sequential way. The reason being, I have told you about the scheme of examination. Chemistry is here accounting for 38 marks. So if you just imagine that if you plan your study in a well strategically, this will help you in achieving the rank, because the students are preparing for a long time. And since the notification came late this time, what I believe is that now you have to strategically understand and pay more attention to the chemistry, because chemistry this time will decide the rank. Then talking about the medium will be completely English. You have to fill the form timely. Don't wait till the last moment. Fill it prior. The questions appearance on the screen should be clear. And you have, my dear students, you have to understand this fact very carefully, that since the examination is very important for pharmacy people, this is the route to your NIPER, this is the route to your BHU, this is the route for your all the good colleges. So getting good rank is not that much difficult. Believe me, if you work hard, if you utilize this time, I have seen many students who have cleared the examination, they have qualified the examination. It is not that much tough. Gain your confidence, devote your more time, and this hard work will pay you a long way. So my sincere advice to all of you is that devote more time for the GPAT preparation now. Don't waste the time. Plan strategically, go through each and every subject and work in whatever way you feel in the best way. Thank you so much, everyone. In my upcoming videos also, I will be sharing the important facts related to the GPAT. Also, I will be sharing few questions which I, even if I am able to help few students, that will really mean a lot, because what I believe is that the people who goes through the GPAT and they qualify, they gain that sort of the confidence which is very much essential to grow in the life. So my dear students, if you have any doubt or query, or if you want to make ask me to make some other video sessions, please reply in the comment section. Thank you so much, everyone. Keep watching and sharing from ECPTR.